That's correct, family. We're coming out. We're coming out sharing the good news, the great news with you on this Tuesday. Attitude of gratitude. We always grateful on Tuesdays. Inner Light Radio Show. Tuesday, June 26, 2012. First, giving honor to the creator of this universe and all that inhabits it, and to my mother, Shirley Hardy, the elder in my life, I greet you all in love and kindness today. I'm Dr. K, and you are listening to Health Talk Healthwise. What's your illusion? What's your reality? Conscious Healthcare Talk with Dr. K and friends right here on innerlightradio.com, the healing frequency. For additional information on anything that you hear on this show, you can go to my website, www.cellife.com. Or you can call me on 202-248-7749. Remember, family, this show honors all who have and all that will emancipate from medical mental slavery. That's correct, family. It's time to bury disease thinking. Are you ready to eradicate disease thinking from your mind? What's your illusion and what's your reality? I invite you to go to my website and download the free ebook, Heal Yourself and Others by Mastering Energy and Information. That's at cellife.com. I practice in the non-secular science of health and healing as a conscious NES health practitioner. I teach or interest you in how to properly care for the physical body and in the cause and prevention of disease or dis-ease. I use the NES Provision System to reveal to you what you are training your body to do and what your body is telling you that it needs for you to do in order to correct the cellular malfunctions, information distortions, and activate the self-healing powers of the body. Are you ready? I'm ready. Are you ready to get on board the soul train of healthcare freedom? We are taking a Harriet Tubman's ride, a ride from pharmacide, nutricide, and yes, oh yes, the sad, and I do mean sad, standard American diet. Now, family community, you don't need a ticket. There's nowhere to go to buy your ticket. You just get on board and let freedom ring. That's what we're going to do. Let freedom ring. Yeah, I'm Dr. K, and I am looking to talk with individuals that have emancipated themselves from medical mental slavery. If you have done this and you are free of all medication and you have reversed your so-called name diseases, we want to hear from you, family. This show is really about you. We want you to come on and share your journey to healthcare freedom to help someone else emancipate themselves from medical mental slavery as well. So in my workshops, I say it's time to relearn, rethink, and rewrite your personal healthcare plan. What will your new prescription be? Will you create on your health journey? It's time to learn and live the natural laws of life and health, the mental, nutritional, physical, and emotional laws of health. Joining the conversation this hour is Wanda Whitaker, anchored in spirit. She should be joining us in and out of the conversation today. Reverend Dorita Dixon. Reverend from the Institute of Spiritual Enlightenment, and Miss Rachel Pope with Let's Talk Wisdom, Blessings Flow Empower, and Andy Evans, the comedy counselor with the Comedy Counselor Stress Relief Moment, will all be joining the conversation today. Remember, you are listening to Health Talk Healthwise. What's your illusion? What's your reality? Conscious Healthcare Talk with Dr. K and friends right here on innerlightradio.com. You can email your questions or comments to innerlightradio@yahoo.com. That's innerlightradio@yahoo.com. You can also call us in with your positive conversation, anything you want to share that's positive about what we're talking about or what we have talked about. We look forward to hearing from you. That number is 310-928-7733. That's 310-928-7733. Please mute your phone, and I will announce you to join the conversation by your phone number. You can connect with me on Skype at Mindfulness for Health, the number 4. Social media family, you can connect with me on Facebook, Karen Davis Folks, and we'd like you to like our page, Emancipate Yourself from Medical Mental Slavery. Visit my YouTube channel. We've got some fun videos out there for you. That's at K Davis F as in Frank. K Davis F as in Frank. It's time to take back control of your life and your health. The point of this show is to help. That's health education for longevity and peace. You change your thinking and feeling nature, move up to a higher frequency and consciousness, and clear the channels so that you can live infinite possibilities of love in your life. This is what we want for each and every one of you, the same thing we want for ourselves. So I would like to greet my friends in the chat room right now. Let me see who's joining me. Let me look up on the screen. All right, Reverend Dorita Dixon, how you doing today?
Hey, Dr. Karen, I'm doing wonderfully well, marvelously well. I'm enjoying this weather here in Washington, D.C., and it's just been a very nice... I'm happy, that's all. I'm happy.
I know you're happy. You're riding on the waves of Frank Talk from yesterday. Frank Talk, ooh, real talk.
Yes, I am. I am happy.
Looking forward to many more broadcasting of Frank Talk. Thank you for joining me in the trap room. Ms. Rachel Pope, how you doing today?
Living my life like it's golden, living my life like it's golden. Yes, sir. That's how I'm feeling.
Taking it off the shelf and moving on with it. Got to live our life like it's golden. Wanda, thanks for joining us in today. I know you're going to be coming in and out of the conversation today, but so glad you could be online listening with us.
No problem. I'm going to give you a little bit of earth, wind, and fire because I've got my head to the sky, living sunshine.
I like it. What y'all feeling out there, family? How y'all feeling today? Wonderful to have you join us. You know, it's nice when every 2 weeks we come behind on Jamila and she channels John Christopher. And I just love to hear the things that John Christopher has to say and Jamila explaining it. So it was a great show today. I'd like to remind you all that, you know, we do not discuss diseases or dis-ease care on this show. However, we do address the question, could you still be in the dark ages of healthcare? And that just simply means that you just not have been aware of the new information and all the new things that are going on. Great opportunities for us not to feel like we are just stuck in this allopathic way of doing things. And so we're asking you to actually look at that information that you're processing for your health and see if it needs to be upgraded or reprogrammed or maybe even buy some new software or something. You know, that's what we're talking about. And we also want you to consider if you're working from a man-made mindset of human consciousness in healthcare and in life, that means all those programs they put in our heads and repeatedly gave to us over and over and over again, you know, are they serving you? Is it time for you to begin to come up with some new information, some new value systems for yourself, just some new information? So we want to give you an opportunity to be able to look into these areas of your life through this show and hopefully help you make some good positive changes for yourself. Because at any moment, you know, we can do that. We can make the change for ourselves just by simply saying so. Today's topic, we are asking the questions, where are you today? The biophysics of pathology. You know, last week we talked about Western pathology. Today we're going to finish up with Western pathology and talk a little bit about Eastern pathology. And then we'll end up with biophysics pathology, where we are right now in quantum health and healing. And so what I'd like for you to do, family, are you ready? You're ready? Set back. Set back and become a master of your health and your life. Set back and take a deep, deep, deep breath. I mean, feel it from the bottom of your toes. Feel it move up your legs. Feel it reach your abdominal. Feel it come up to your chest. Feel your lungs. Feel your heart expand. Feel that breath coming all the way up as it moves up your throat, as it comes up to your brain and expand your brain and expand your awareness to the new human being that you can be. Feel it. Take that deep, deep breath. And then relax. And listen here as we whisper in your ear, universal truths that you will hold so dear, because the secrets of healthcare are now being revealed about cellular ecology and the new paradigm, informational healthcare. I'm Dr. Khadijah Abdul-Malik, also known as Dr. K, and you are listening to Health Talk Healthwise. What's your illusion? What's your reality? Remember, we will take your positive conversation. You can call us on 310-928-7733. You can also email your questions and comments to innerlightradio@yahoo.com. Before we get into the conversation through the soul of Mayat, as we continue with Western pathology coming into Eastern pathology, we're going to go for a commercial break, and we'll be right back. Greetings and love and kindness. Tired of going to practitioner after practitioner? Tired of going to doctor after doctor? Tired of taking all that medication that's not serving you? Are you tired? Are you tired? Are you tired? Well, I'm Dr. Karen Davis, folks, and I'm here to give you energy and information. I am a certified NES provision practitioner. Step up to the future in healthcare. It's time for a new approach. I'm Dr. Karen Davis, folks. Call me on 202-248-7749, 202-248-7749, or visit www.cellife.com and join the NES Health Practitioners and step up to the future in healthcare. It is time to bury disease thinking. Peace and love, Dr. Karen Davis. That's correct, family. It's time to bury disease thinking. And when you know the divine being that you are, you will have no problem in doing that. When you accept the divine being that you are, you will begin to live that. Today's topic, once again, is Western pathology and Eastern pathology. We're going to finish up from last weekend. Thank you all for your emails and your conversation and the workshop that I did through Skype based on the discussion last week talking about Western pathology and allopathic medicine. And I'm going to share a little bit of that conversation through that workshop that everybody felt that I should share before I went and started talking about Eastern pathology today. So we're going to do a little bit of that, and you'll be able to chime in on some of the questions that we came up with. So the conversation through the soul of Mayat, when a solution to a problem seems impossible, the answer lies in infinite possibilities. The biophysics of pathology. Again, fundamentally, pathology is about understanding why and how people become ill, and from this knowledge, determining ways of dealing with illness and diseases. And you know, we call that cellular malfunctions that we can correct because we know we established an organized breakdown. But nevertheless, Western and Eastern medical practice have developed highly sophisticated yet significantly different means of diagnosing and explaining health issues. Both systems have their place, and the new system of biophysics has extended these principles by looking at the body functions with an open mind, as we ask you to do here each and every Tuesday, and also through a detailed understanding of quantum chemistry, which has brought a new understanding of pathology and treatment methods, and one of that is through NES Health. Today we will look at the Western pathology and the Eastern pathology from biophysics perspective. And each of my friends in the chat room and hopefully you will share your personal perspective. We are given the impression that scientists can now explain all the body's operating functions through biochemistry and DNA analysis. We know that is the Western understanding of determining what's going on through tests and your symptoms that you tell them. They run these tests and then they tell you that something is wrong with you and you need their assistance to correct it. But yet a growing number of top genetic and biochemical research admits that the deeper they delve into the knowledge to the works of the human chemistry, the less they really seem to understand. They are paradoxes and unexplainable phenomenons, missing links, and a growing awareness that something else is required to connect all the bits and processes together. And we say that is definitely our consciousness, to become aware that we play a major role in how this body functions. So there seems to be an element missing in the biochemical model. That's the model that we're talking about. This lack of understanding is most clearly demonstrated by the poor recovery rates of people suffering from chronic health conditions. We know that we have people that have been dealing with their issues for 10, 20, 30, 40 years and not living the best quality life that they can. And we want to help put a change to that, that you don't have to live and manage a disease, that you can understand that there's cellular malfunctions and you can make the changes accordingly once you're exposed to the right information. And that's what we're doing here, wanting to expose you to the right information. For many years, eminent researchers have observed that biochemical processes are accompanied by energetic phenomena. They kind of work together. These phenomena do not fit into the traditional biochemical model and are not explainable through chemistry alone. You know, they really don't know how a wound heals itself, you know, by itself. You may put a cast on it, but internally it's doing the healing, and they just don't understand how that is to be from the Western model. But we know through the energetic model and now the biophysic model, we understand how that is possible. But there have been investigations and samplings and shows about the new terminology and a new way of understanding, or maybe we can say the acceptance of Eastern medicine over here now. We can understand why, because of some of the research that has come out of their research here in the United States. And in the early 1940s, a gentleman found a way to identify the energy field that surrounds all living beings, what she called the L field or the living field. And that field is now being known as the human body field. And we know it through the fields of the aura. And so that was one of the things that came out in 1940 that really cemented people with understanding and becoming more in tune with Eastern medicine. And then we also know about the Kirkland development, a technique to view the body's aura field made visible through high voltage charges across a photographic plate. Then we know in 1950, Dr. Robert produced a large body of research showing the presence of electrocurrents in the skin and identified the importance in regenerating tissue. So there's a lot of research that has been done to make us fully understand that we're not limited to this biochemical model of how they feel that genes control everything. And there's a whole new frontier, because we know that Professor Kim, he traced the acupuncture meridians with radioactive isotopes in the 60s. And the following decade, we had Fritz Popp, who discovered biophoton, because you hear Wanda and I talking about, you ain't nothing but a photon, just bouncing all around. And that's where we are right now in quantum health and healing. So there's been a lot of information out there that just has not gotten down into the community level for people to understand that they're not limited to just this one side of information. So that's a little bit about what we talked about last week about the Western side. And through the workshop that I had based on that class, we end up having a discussion. And what I did was I had individuals write the 10 biggest healthcare lies in America. So friends in the chat room, I want you to think about what is going to be your number one, maybe, healthcare lie in America. So I'm going to share a few with you and then y'all can discuss that. And you can also call in and say how you feel about what we talked about on 310-928-7733. So one of the big lies, I think, is vaccines make you healthy, because that's where we are right now. Everything is becoming a vaccine, and they want to say that makes you healthy. Well, what do you think about that? I don't believe it. I don't believe in that one little bit. You can tell me what you think about that in a moment, friends, in my chat room. One of the other lies that I think is told, that pharmaceuticals prevent disease. We think if we take a pharmaceutical that we're going to prevent our bodies from having this disease. That's because we don't understand what causes cellular malfunctions in the body, and we're here to help you understand that. So pharmaceuticals, as a drugless practitioner, you know that pharmaceuticals, from my point of view, does not help the body. They hinder the body. They're not kin, no kind to the body. And another thing, we think doctors are expert in health. And I mean, that's all the fields, because if we are the experts, then what we really should be doing is helping you to educate yourself so that you can become your own doctor. And then we are truly experts. One of the other things is you have no role in your own healing. That's what they want you to believe, that you have no role in your own healing. And we're here to tell you that you have the role in your healing and in your life. Another thing that holds us back, definitely in the African-American community, is disease is a matter of bad luck or bad genes. And that is simply not true. That's an excuse for you not to do better for yourself. So we're asking you to let that go. One of the main things they tell us to do is getting a lot of our brothers concerned with going in for checkup. They want you to believe that screening equals prevention. We know that's early detection. And so if you don't want to hear the bad news, then come to a bioenergetic practitioner or alternative practitioner that's not practicing in disease care, that's fully embraced in what they say they are. And we should not be telling you that you have or going to get a disease. We tell you that you have cellular malfunctions, that organs are not properly functioning well, and how you can address those things. So I'm going to go to my friends in the chat room, and that's just a few that we talked about when we had our workshop, and see how they feel about this and what maybe is a top lie they think that's being told in allopathic medicine is keeping our people in the dark ages of healthcare. I think I'll start with you, Reverend Dorita, if you don't mind today.
Well, we certainly have to get our folks out of this thinking that they have a disease, because once you start owning it, you know, these diseases, you make it real in your own consciousness. I've even heard people call, I believe it's arthritis, Uncle Arthur. And I said, what? But this is what people are doing. They are owning the dis-ease as opposed to saying, I am free, I am clear of, you know, diseases. So it's going to take us a while. It's going to take a minute. No, I take it back. It's going to happen automatically as they start tuning into the radio station here. People are going to start waking up all over the United States and understand what it is that Dr. Karen is trying to give us. Am I learning?
Bringing yourself to the truth that you know. And that's what we do. We quicken ourselves to the truth that we know. And I think really what you're saying, Reverend Dorita, is we develop language. We don't even realize that we use language.
Yes.
We call it my disease, my arthritis, my this, my that. And then we also say my doctor, you know, and I even know someone that went so far to say my boyfriend. You know, and I mean, that's just giving too much to them, giving too much of your control of life to them. And you don't want to be that victim and stuck in that model of healthcare any longer. So language is very important, because we know words speak truth, and words is just like thought. Form comes into manifestation through the spoken words. So we need to look at our language. And baby, stop saying mine, I have, and things like that. Your consciousness will change. That's what we're talking about. How you doing today, Ms. Rachel Pope? What you'd like to chime into and say and speak on?
I'll sit out here like, which one? Oh, my goodness. You know I got a little.
You got one. Long.
Yeah, I'm like, just stop telling lies. Doctors, you know, like you just said, you know, my boyfriend, my this and my that, but based on my own experience, being a guinea pig through 7 doctors, and my friends, get another opinion, get it. I'm like, well, this is how I'm feeling. I took all my notes because I knew my own body. They ain't even look at it. And then I'm like, they ain't even pay attention to what I'm saying. And I'm like, every detail down, it's 7 doctors now. And I'm like, okay, are you looking, listening to me? Instead of taking me through all these tests and spending all my money on all this and insurance pending and all that crap, I'm like, you know what? I'm going to go to this lady and talk to her and see what she thinks. She was willing to listen and look at my own chart that I've written of my own self. And I asked her, do you have anything against me going to alternatives? And she said no. She said, try that first because I'm not a specialist at it. Now, I like that. Now, she gave me an option. You know, she, I'm like, uh-uh. And that's why I am where I'm at. I ain't been back since then.
Well, that's wonderful that she gave you an option. You know, a lot of that is happening today in the Western field. They are becoming in agreeance, or they want to say, yes, you can do nutrition. That will support you. Yes, you can seek using herbs that will assist you, but you still have a disease and you still. Still need to do this surgery, or you may still need to have this take this medication. That's the line that we want to separate. We want to break that line right there and say to you that the two don't mix. It's like oil and water doesn't mix. It's not a good match. You may say it is for you, and if you say so, then that's what you bring yourself, and the outcome will be what you gave yourself. But in reality of the fact, no, it's not a good match. One thing works, not both. You can't say you want health care focusing on a disease. You can't say you want to regain your health trying to get rid of a disease. It's just like we heard a few minutes ago on the show before us with Jamila, you know, focus on you. Use your voice. Use good words. Pay attention to what you're saying, and you will get that in life. Wanda, do you want to share anything with us on this point right here?
Well, you know, I can really talk about what happened to me this weekend because mm-hmm. I had some flu-like symptoms and had a temperature of 105. And it wasn't until I got that temperature of 105 until a friend said, you know, you need to go to the hospital. I'm sitting there thinking, I am more than who I think I am. And so I said, okay, I took the guy's recommendation, and I went to the emergency room, and I sat there, and he finally called on me, I guess because I had a temperature of 105. And I sat there, and they started to look at me. And first thing they did was took my blood pressure. And I know that my blood pressure is okay, but I said to myself, I know what blood pressure is. And because I know who I am and how the body works, I was able to get my blood pressure to like 117 just by going into trance. That's all I did. I went into trance. And that just cooled the body down. And finally, my temperature broke and everything was okay. And they told me the only thing you have is the flu. But the next thing they did was that they came in and they said, you know, you'll need a CAT scan. I said, I don't need a CAT scan. You've got to be out of your mind. And then the person, I guess he was an internist or whatever, or the nurse, went back to the doctor and says, you know, she doesn't want to take a CAT scan. And the doctor comes back in and he tells me, oh, you have to take a CAT scan. We won't be able to see. I said, I don't do radiation and you don't need to do a CAT scan. And then three people came back and told me, oh, well, we just want to take x-rays. I said, that's still radiation. And the doctor said, no, that's like staying sitting out in the sun. I said, no, N-O. And finally, they left me alone. They let me go, and then I continued my process, my own process, when I went home. It's the ginger tea and just really, really concentrating on who I am, really.
And that's what, yeah.
Talking to myself, spending time with myself and my God, and I feel so much better today.
And I think that's what those symptoms say to us, is time to rest. Our immune system is saying that it needs support for us. It needs support in helping us correct some things. And so that's what we're talking about, knowing your body, knowing what to do. And even if you go to seek some understanding as to about what it is, you should know that there is a better way to support yourself. And you don't need to take every x-ray or every exam that they offer to you just because your insurance will cover it. Because matter of fact, that was also one of the top lies that we talked about. Health insurance will keep you healthy. Will health insurance keep you healthy? That's a big question. I don't know. Will health insurance keep you healthy? I don't think so. I'm healthy and I don't have health insurance. I haven't paid for any and don't plan on paying for any, even though they say that we have to. I'll go get the free first before I do that. So we're talking about looking at a different way of supporting yourself. And we're just talking about some of the things that we shared in the workshop, some of the things for you to think about. Hospitals are places of health and healing. Are hospitals truly a place of health and healing? If you want to stay healthy or get healthy, a hospital is the very last place you will want to find yourself. They are unhappy, unhealthy places that are infected with antibiotic-resistant superbugs. I know every time I go into the hospital and spend time with people, which I try to do very sparingly, I come in covered up completely because it's just full of germs, and you'll leave there with something that you will have to work to remove from your body or try to bring your immune system down, because we don't catch anything. It's the level that our immune system is functioning that we will experience some type of cellular malfunction. And that is just, again, a message from your body saying to you that you need to rest, you need to give it proper nourishment, you need to give it sunshine, you need to even get good sleep, take better care of yourself. That's what the body's messages are saying to us. There's also one other big lie, that more research is needed to find cures, and we think that is the biggest lie because most of your leading organizations that have been out there for almost 300 years, they haven't found a cure yet, and they keep telling you to fight and struggle until they do so. And wouldn't you like to change that paradigm? Wouldn't you like to give somebody some good news? Would you like to tell them to tune into Health Talk Healthwise? What's your illusion? What's your reality? And create a whole new concept of understanding. What we're going to do is we're going to take a commercial break, and we're going to come back, and I'm just going to give you a little bit of understanding how they diagnose in the Eastern pathology. So we're going to go for a commercial break. You are listening to Health Talk Healthwise. What's your illusion? What's your reality? Conscious Healthcare Talk right here on innerlightradio.com, the healing frequencies. Want to get the best out of your nutritional program? Then you should be using Progeny 9 Plus. Are you taking supplements after supplements after supplements and your health is not getting any better? Are you taking the best supplements that you can get, nutritional supplements, and your health are not getting any better? Could it be that your cardiovascular system and your lymphatic system, all your capillaries and all your veins are blocked and clogged up? Then you need to step up to Progeny 9 Plus. Visit cellife.com and step up to Progeny 9 Plus today. Click on the link, watch the videos, and join the self-care revolution with Progeny 9 Plus and get the best out of your nutritional program. For additional information, call me, Dr. K, on 202-248-7749. Step up to Progeny 9 Plus and make the best out of your nutritional supplement program today. That's right. Stepping up to Progeny 9. For those that are not familiar with my practice, most people know that I'm basically a conscious healthcare practitioner. We work through the consciousness, but we know there is a manifested being. The body is manifested, and it does need certain things to function. And because I say we don't have diseases, we have cellular malfunctions, I look in terms to see as what is the underlying root problems that may be causing all the problems. And as a doctor of lymphology, we know how important the lymphatic system is and how important the vascular system is. And oftentimes people's vascular system is clogged up and the blood flow is not very well. Progeny 9 Plus actually helps to create nitric oxide and help it stay in the body for 24 hours. And when you open up your capillaries, your blood vessels, your veins, and allow the information, the blood, and everything that runs smoothly through the body to nourish your cells, to nourish the organs, then they'll get what they need in their function. And when your lymphatic system is at its optimal, which is the key driver of the immune system, when that system is able to purify the body, because a lot of things stay in the body. You eliminate organs can be working well, but there are certain things that stay in the body that must be purified. And those systems are not functioning well, then we have a hard time getting to the health level that we want. And so I do promote Progeny 9 Plus because of what it does, because it is one of the only clinically researched products from the Heart Association, not the Medical Heart Association, but from a alternative practitioner as well as an MD practitioner. They have researched and used Progeny 9 Plus in clinical studies, as well as the founder of Progeny 9, Dr. Pendergrass, who was awarded Father of the Year in 2008 because he is a high-risk diabetic doctor. And by switching his clients to Progeny 9, he just eliminated putting people in the hospital for over 18 years. So this is a wonderful product. It really works, and it will help your nutrients work better in your body once these areas are cleaned and flowing to allow the fluids of the body to move like the oceans of the world. Fluidity flowing, free of stagnation, blockages, and lack of quality oxygen. That's what we're talking about. I think we have a caller on the line. I'm going to let come in. I think a caller is calling in from 202-561. Okay, I see the call on the line. Maybe they're not ready to come in. So what we're going to do is we're going to let Reverend Dorita come in and share with us from the book that we're asking you to download, a free book that will allow you the opportunity to understand what we're talking about in this field of quantum health and healing. Healing yourself and others by mastering energy and information. Reverend Dorita Dixon, what you want to share with us from the book today that people can go look at?
Well, I wanted to say, first of all, when Wanda was speaking about going to the hospital, sometimes mm-hmm. we have to do that. It's like a wake-up call to our own physical body, because I think once she got into that hospital and she realized where she was.
I know.
You know, she said, you know what? It's like a wake-up call for us, and we do that. And she went, and first thing she said, I went inside and I meditated. She went inside. So she went inside of herself to ask herself, you know, let's do this. Let's calm down the body. Let's get ourselves in order. And then as the rest of the outside people started knocking at her door and asking her to do certain things, she said, no, no, no. And she started waking up. You understand what I'm saying? You understand? She was waking up to herself, who she was, and she started, the healing process started right there. So, you know, people, if you've got to go to hospital to get that wake-up call, go ahead. You're going to wake up. One way or the other, you're going to wake up. Right. I just thought I'd put that in there.
That was wonderful.
But in the book today, I was looking at page 43 in the Healing Yourself and Others and Mastering the Energy and Information. The opposite is so true. Thinking negative or harmful thoughts about someone may actually affect that person at some deep level. This is not speculation or science fiction, as many clinical studies and much lab research have demonstrated that our intentions can affect material things and other people. There was a study recently reported by the New Scientist magazine, 3 Degrees of Contagion, January 3 through 9, 2009, page 24, shows that one of the most important parameters of health is your relationship and their happiness factor. Happiness spreads through social networks. Let me say that one again. Happiness spreads through social networks, family, friends, coworkers, and neighbors, and is actually contagious. Just being around happy people increases your own happiness and improves health. The researchers report that your health condition and habits all turn out to be ruled by a large degree by social forces. The conclusion that reach is that we are who we hang out with. What are your social forces? What is happiness? In reality, they are states of minds and being informational fields. They have the power to affect not only your emotional state, but your physical state as well. So choose your social networks to include people who are satisfied and happy themselves. And you stand to increase your own level of contentment and foster a better state of health.
That is so true. I often tell people, you can't wish ill for someone else and wish well for you. You just can't do that. You cannot have those two thoughts running, because what you put out is going to come back to you. So wish for yourself what you want for everybody else, and let that be the truth, and let that be good.
Karen, can I say something?
And that yes, is, Wanda, go ahead. Then we're going to let Andy come in, and we got Rachel with
Thank you so much, but what she's saying is so true. And for all those who think negatively and evil about someone, they don't realize that that's going to come back on them as well. It just mm-hmm. doesn't stop. It ricochets. It goes back. And secondly, as I was sick, staying home, looking at daytime TV and all the negative programming, it made me sicker. And I understand why most
people
are sick. Looking at that programming, immediately.
That's a vibration.
Immediately, I started looking at I Love Lucy tapes.
That's what we get. Girl, go ahead. And laughter.
Oh, I've got to laugh.
And that's what we get ready to come up on right now. We have Andy Evans on the line, and he's going to bringing us the comedy stress release moment with comedy. So, again, family, we ask you to go and download that free ebook, Healing Yourself and Others by Mastering Energy and Information, and that will help you wake up and find out where you are in your thinking and your paradigm of understanding. And we're going to be sharing with you with that book and work with you through that book. It's also a self-study course that you can take along with that book if you so choose, or you can just download the book. But right now we're going to let Andy come in and greet us and give us a comedy stress release moment. And Wanda, you can get your laugh on right now and get some more health and healing.
I love it.
How you doing, Andy?
Hello there, ladies. How are y'all doing today?
Wonderful.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes!
Yes.
Oh, I thought maybe I wasn't coming through well. I'm going to just say good afternoon to you all. And sure, I'm going to share with you some letters in my comedy moment mailbag. In fact, it fits right along with today's program. We're talking about all this good health. In fact, I got a letter here today from my comedy counselor mailbag that reads, say comedy counselor, I'm going for my first physical exam in 25 years. My wife made me an appointment and told me I bet not miss it. She thinks I'm afraid to have a physical. It's not that. It's just that physicals have changed over the years. Instead of worrying about heart and blood pressure, the first thing they want to do with a man is put his feet up to some stirrups and examine his prostate. What's that all about? One of the guys told me that they're going to shave my lower extremities. Oh, no. Another told me that they're going to have to put my feet up in stirrups. Now, tell me, that nurse said I have to come prepped. My wife said, take it like a man and relax and breathe. Oh, God. You don't mean to scare the prostate. Your ladies know that, don't you? We can't stand the thought of somebody invading our bodies, although I think women are more accustomed to it, as they say. So I know it's easy for y'all to have gone through that. It's not an easy thing for most men. So I just say to my boy, he's from Prostate, Pennsylvania. That's where he's from, Prostate, Pennsylvania. I do declare. So let me just say to the brother, first off, you know, I think we all at that point now where we all should be getting our physical, especially the guys, because, you know, sometimes guys have let that prostate become a problem because they don't get a physical. I'd say go get the physical. Just don't wait another 25 years to have one. Listen to what your wife says. Take an extra breath. And remember, women outlive men 8-1. Go get that physical. And between me and you, I wouldn't put my feet in no stirrups. I'm going to tell you right now. Hey, this is the comedy council said, take a deep breath. Now don't you feel better?
I tell you what I really want to say. I have to say for Frank Talk Radio.
Well, you know, it's amazing how guys, you know, we can't take pain. But women can take pain because y'all have babies. So it's harder for us to relax and think about something invading us. And I think that's why so many men go so long without having a physical. But, you know, I figure that at this stage, if you got to 60 and you ain't took a prostate exam and you worrying about, cause I think someone worrying about their manhood. I think it's a little late at that stage to worry about your manhood. I think you should worry about survival at this stage. So I'm encouraging all the men to listen to the program. Please go get a physical. Get yourself checked out. Don't wait till the last moment because, you know, that's really our problem. And this show is really trying to encourage people not only to take care of their body, but to be responsible for taking care of your body.
And
your
I tell
health.
You what, brothers, if you do go and you do have that physical, we talked about the pre-screening and what it really is that is just really preparing you for something. And if they say you do have it, I just talked to you about Progeny 9+. We just need to get that circulation moving in the body, and it covers everything. So it doesn't matter what disease you have. The problem is you have constriction and you have inflammation. And if you open up those vessels, vessels, open up those lymphatic vessels, you won't have the problem and you won't be concerned with poor circulation, not a so-called name of a disease. So we're asking you to step on up to healthcare. We're going to go straight
in. Well, Dr. K, could I ask you a question?
Mm-hmm.
Doc, could I ask you a question?
Yes, you
can. Could I ask you a question? The question I want to ask, you know, I know women sometimes when they have babies, they have the man come in there with them when the baby is being born and hold their hand. I just want to know, could you volunteer to go with the men? I think a lady should go with the men when we have our prostate exam, because, you know, we're not brave when it comes down to
women. Well, I tell you what, see,
put our hand through the process.
You wouldn't have anybody come with me because it won't be invasive and we can tell you what's going on. That's a part of the new frontier. So to all the brothers that don't want to go have that invasive test to find out what's going on with their body as a whole, not in sections like allopathic does, that's what we've been talking about. We're talking about the whole body. Then come to me if no one else is doing it. We can talk about it. We can find another way to let you know what's going on with your body, to step that up. But if you want to do it the other way, then women will step up, right, ladies? Will we go
oh,
there?
Oh, yes. I'll volunteer. I'm a hand holder. I'll go and hold a gentleman's hand.
Any brother, go call us up. We'll come hold your hand.
I'll come hold your hand. And we can go tiptoeing through the tulips with it.
I know people want to talk.
Guys can call Dr. K's, Dr. K, men can call your program and ask for any of those ladies to go with them to that next physical. Am I right about that? I just never heard that. I heard some volunteers. And then
yes.
Dr. K, holding ladies.
We'll help.
Three ladies in there.
That's
okay.
My sound is leaving out of my headset for some reason. I can barely hear everyone. So if I seem a little off, that's what's going on. But I'm going to let Rachel come in and do Let's Talk Wisdom. And then we can talk about what Andy talked about, what Rachel talked about, what we all talking about. I want to thank the caller that called in. If you do want to call back after Rachel do her story, you can. So Rachel Pope, Let's Talk Wisdom.
Good day, everyone. This is Rachel Pope, known as the Visionary. Well, I'm going to give you my life golden journey for this week. It's about emotion, time, and love. Once upon a time, there was an island where all the feelings lived, happiness, sadness, knowledge, and all the others, including love. One day, it was announced that the feelings of this island, that the island would sink. So all constructed boats and left, except for love. Love was the only one who stayed. Love wanted to hold out until the last possible moment. When the island had almost sunk, love decided to ask for help. Richness was passing by love in a grand boat. Love said, Richness, can you take me with you? Richness answered, No, I can't. There's a lot of gold and silver in my boat. There's no place for you here. Love decided to ask Vanity, who was also passing by in a beautiful vessel. Vanity, please help me. I can't help you, love. You are all wet and might damage my boat, Vanity answered. Sadness was close by, so love asked Sadness, let me go with you. Oh, love, I'm so sad. I need to be by myself. Happiness passed by love, too, but she was so happy that she did not even hear when love called her. Sadly, there was a voice. Come, love, I will take you. It was an elder. So blessed and overjoyed, love even forgot to ask the elder where they were going. When they arrived at the dry land, the elder went to her own way, realizing how much was owed to the elder. Love asked knowledge, another elder, who helped me? Who helped me? It was time, knowledge answered. Time, asked love. But why did time help me? Knowledge now with deep wisdom and answered, because only time is capable of understanding how valuable love is. So, the more of this story, time is more valuable than anything except love. because we're supposed to learn from life lessons, experiences. The experiences teaches you patience. So that's what I have to say about that story. And I love the way it was written. All right. Love you all. This is Visionary Rachel Pope.
Thank you very much, Visionary Rachel Pope. I really couldn't hear that, so I'm going to go to Wanda and ask Wanda, can you talk in terms of what Rachel just spoke of, and then Andy, and then Reverend Dorita.
Well, first of all, love is all there is. All else is an illusion. And we come here from the spiritual world to learn how to love. There is nothing but love from where we came from. And sometimes we have to learn how to love unconditionally. And when we're here, contrast there to allow us to judge and to determine which makes us feel good, which makes us feel bad. And so that's the way I look at that story. Love is all it is. All else is illusion.
Okay. I'm not hearing, but I guess, Andy, you up next?
Yes. Well, let me just say love is. However, I do believe sometimes people confuse love and being in love, which sometimes takes a different road. If you're in love with somebody, you can fall out of love and be disappointed. But if you love for the sake of life, forgiving and sharing, then it's always there is no other partner other than you and your belief in your God force in you. So I kind of think sometimes we're afraid of love because we think of love as having to be in love with someone. When I suggest, like Richard said, love is, so be in love with yourself and that will you never lose.
I heard a little bit of that, and I think that we're talking about love, and love, yeah. All we need is love, love, L-O-V-E, yeah. Laws of vibrational energy. That's what we share here, the love that you are vibrational energy, that is love, so it's who you are, and when you resist yourself, that's when you get into all these conflicts out here, so if you work from the love being that you are, you won't have all this resistance, you won't have all this conflict that you're having. Before I let Reverend Dorita Dixon come in and share what she's going to say, I want to play her commercial so we can let people and remind people of her upcoming show on next Monday. So, Jamal, can we put that commercial up about Reverend Dorita's show? And then she can come in and chime in about the conversation. While he's bringing that in, I just want to remind you that you are listening to Health Talk Healthwise. What's your illusion? What's your reality? Conscious Health Care Talk. Dr. K and friends, right here on Internet Radio. We are here every Tuesday at 3:30 Eastern Standard Time, and I believe that's 12:30 Pacific Time. And we're doing it for you to be part of the conversation. We really want to hear your success stories. I know you know someone that has emancipated themselves, that are doing wonderful things, and want to share their. So we really like that to happen.
Greetings and love and kindness, family. This is Dr. K from Health Talk Healthwise. I am inviting you to tune in starting Monday, June 25th from 7:30 to 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Frank Talk with Reverend Dorita Dixon from the Institute of Spiritual Enlightenment. Join the conversation starting Monday, June 25th. 7:30 to 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, right here on InnerLightRadio.com with Reverend Dorita Dixon of the Institute of Spiritual Enlightenment, Frank Talk. Join in, be a part of the conversation. All topics are open for discussion. Tune in starting Monday, June 25th, 7:30 to 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time with Reverend Dorita Dixon, Frank Talk. Come into the airwaves of InnerLightRadio.com. Tune in and be a part of the conversation. We're looking forward to hearing from you, family. Peace and love.
Greetings and love.